Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television! Yay!
For the community, by the community.
The Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspire Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that's designed to equip you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'd like to begin today's broadcast by extending special gratitude to all of you who have been providing me feedback, who have been, you know, just sending me letters and emails and words of encouragement to let me know how this program has really been inspiring you. I really do thank you so much for taking the time to communicate and to render your feedback. I'm really grateful for it. I want to really encourage you to keep them coming. You know, I thrive on your feedback. Apart from thriving on it, apart from receiving strength and encouragement from it to keep on keeping on, it also affords me the opportunity to know how I could serve you better and how I can improve on the program. So, you know, please do keep those comments coming in. Thank you so much. I'm really excited about today's broadcast. I know I say that all the time. I'm always excited about today's broadcast. But really, I'm truly excited about this month's topic because it comes by way of a challenge. I have titled this month's topic, Embracing Change, a Summer Challenge. Yes, Embracing Change, a Summer Challenge. And I'll be talking more about the challenge later that I'm posing to you this month. However, I'm going to start first by talking about embracing change. If you've been following the broadcast for the past couple of months, I was talking about 2 months ago, I believe I was talking about it's a new day. I was talking about new day, new strategies and new tools. And, you know, I've been talking about newness and a new day and change because the wind of change really has been blowing the way of the planet Earth since the year 2006. Really, God has been transitioning us. We've been undergoing a transition. You know, there's been a shift, you know, in God's creation and in his people. And the scripture that comes to my mind is Isaiah 43:18, where it says, "Behold, I do a new thing." You know, it's like God was in that scripture talking about doing a new thing. He was talking through the prophet Isaiah about doing a new thing. Well, today God is also talking to through Prophet Bola, you know, that he's doing a new thing. The wind of change is become evident in our government, in our politics, you know, in our economy, in our social, cultural life, and in our families. And but what I've found is that most people, in spite of this wind of change, which is blowing strongly and profusely in their directions, many individuals are still very resistant to change. They are refusing to embrace change nor come to terms with it, you know. And if you don't embrace the change or come to terms with change, you cannot experience change in your life. And there are several reasons why people are resistant to change. The number one being the fact that most people are ignorant of the power of change. They fail to realize that change is a good thing, that change is a blessing. The other reason being that people are uncomfortable with change. The thought being that change is unfamiliar and change feels unsafe. And so for these reasons, people tend to resist change, you know, and I'm putting it in a nutshell, people are afraid of change. Yes, that's what I said. The fear factor is the singular and key reason, is one of the key reasons why people resist change, you know. Fear of failure, you know, will I fail if I make this change, you know. And so you hear them saying things like, you know, I'm afraid, you know, I don't like it, you know, it's all new to me. Will it work? You know, how will it turn out? So this fear factor is one of the key reasons why people resist change. And the second key reason why people resist change is what I call pride in success or achievement. These are the people who resist change because they say that, you know, I'm successful at what I'm doing. You know, they say that change is for failures. You know, I've found a workable system. I've developed a workable system that's getting me results. So why do I need to change? You know? And so I want to speak to those individuals out there who are in this category. I call it the success trap. You know, these are the people in the success trap. You're successful and what you've developed and the system you've discovered works for you, and so you're trapped, really, and you don't want to make change. So I want to speak to us today and about, first, the power of change, you know, 9 powers of change. And this is basically why change is good, and why change, the reasons why change is good, and the reasons why change must be embraced. So don't forget that I'm talking today about embracing change, a summer challenge. So now I'm talking about these 9 reasons, 9 powers of change. The first power of change is that change opens us up to new and exciting ideas, new and exciting projects, new and exciting people, you know. And you know what that does? It broadens our knowledge and it broadens our areas of expertise. You see, so as we are open to new people, as we're open to new ideas, as we're open to new projects, you know, our knowledge, our mind kind of broadens, and our knowledge and our areas of expertise also broaden. So that's a powerful thing. That's a good thing about change. The other thing is that our interpersonal people and communication skills are also improved. Because now you have a broader network of people, you have a broader idea, broader mindset, and so now you are challenged to know how to, you know, communicate and relate and interact better with people. So your personal and interpersonal and communication skills are improved. So that's a good thing, you know. That's one power of change. The second power of change is that change opens us up to new opportunities for material wealth and material blessings, you know, through the newer connections and the newer relationships. Yes, as we embrace change then opens up to all these new people. And so our connections and our relationships are larger and bigger. And there our chances of increased business and material wealth and contracts and deals increases. So that's the second reason. That's another power of change. So you see, change is good. So we're talking about embracing change. You know, this wind of change has been blowing, like I said, and, you know, we don't need to resist it. We don't need to fight it, you know. It needs to be embraced. So that's the second reason, or the second power of change. The third power of change is that, you know, change provides us with new platforms through which we can live our dreams. New platforms through which we can live our dreams, providing us with greater visibility and prominence, you see. So even if you're at one level of success, You know, when you change and you open yourself up to this new opportunities, a new arena, it will give us you a new platform through which you can live your dream. And then your visibility and your prominence is increased. That's another power of change. The fourth power of change is that change provides us with new platforms and opportunities to impact others, broadening or widening our reach and our impact. You know, I'm sure there are many of us, you know, everyone's innate dream. I believe that everyone innate desire, you know, every living person on this planet, every human being has an innate desire to make a difference, you know, to make a difference. And so, you know, by embracing change, you know, these new platforms and these new opportunities are opened up to us to be able to impact others. And so our reach and our impact broadens. Wow, isn't that something wonderful? You see that? So change is powerful, change is good. The fifth power of change is that change makes room for newer blessings to flow into our lives. You know, the analogy I can think of is of like a oak trees. We know that trees go through seasons where they shed their leaves. And the reason why they shed their leaves is to allow for new leaves and new fruit to bud and to blossom, you know? So in other words, what change does is that it affords us the opportunity for newness to come into our lives, for growth to come into our lives, for new opportunities, new blessings to flow into our lives. That's wonderful. That's powerful, really. I mean, you know, I'm coming to, you know, without change, there is no renewal. Without change, get this one now. Without change, there is no renewal and there is no growth. And when there is no renewal and when there is no growth, death begins. And I'm sure death is definitely not on the agenda. It's not for me, definitely not. So you see, that's what change does. It allows newness. It allows new things to come into our life. It makes room for newness, for growth, for new blessings to come into our lives. That's wonderful. So, and then I'm coming to the sixth power of change. I told you there were nine. I guess we're in the year 2009, and it had to be nine. And that's a good way of remembering, you know, all those nine powers of change. So the sixth power of change is that change builds. It actually improves self-esteem. You know, our confidence is garnered as our innate gifts and talents are put to test and strengthened, you see. So when we embrace change and are forced to change, that newness kind of brings out the best in us, you know. It puts to test all those gifts and talents that are kind of been buried right there, some that we didn't even know that we had. And at the end of the day, they are tested, and then you find yourself saying, oh, wow, I never knew I could do that. You know, so I could actually do that. And then esteem is improved. Esteem is developed, you know. And, you know, and that's why we should embrace change. You know, it just reminds me of the individuals that are working behind the scenes today. They're actually volunteering for the first time, you know. And that is a big leap, you know. But it's a good thing to step out of your comfort zone, embrace change, and do something new. And then you would look back and you say, wow, I didn't know I could ever handle a camera this good. You know, so, you know, this is the other power of change. So, and now we're coming to the seventh power of change. I've talked about six powers of change so far, you know, new opportunities, you know, new knowledge and increase interpersonal and communication skills. I've talked about new platforms through which to live your dreams, providing greater visibility and prominence. I've talked about new opportunities to impact others, broadening our reach and impact. I've talked about newer blessings flowing into our lives. I've talked about improved self-esteem. Now I'm coming to the seventh power of change. And that is that change deepens our dependency on God. You see, as our new circumstances force us, it forces us to tap into divine power, to tap into the supernatural, to lift up our heads, you know, because we now realize that we suddenly need God's intervention. We need God's power and grace to overcome the fears and the anxieties that are naturally associated with change. So change does deepen our dependency on God. And anything that deepens our dependency on God is a very good thing. Trust me. You know, it is good to be humble and to trust in the Lord. The eighth power of change, I'm coming close to the end of the nine powers of change. The eighth power of change is that change strengthens our character. It strengthens character as we learn patience and humility. I'm telling you, there's nothing that humbles you like change, because now you suddenly find yourself in a new arena where you probably not experienced, you don't have as much expertise and as much knowledge. And it's, you know, humbling to now come to now have to learn how to, you know, operate in that new arena. So it does build character, and humility is a good thing. It's a virtue, right? I'm sure you know that. And we also learn, the other virtue that we learn is patience. You see, change does not happen overnight. You know, it takes its time, it's a process, and it cannot be rushed, it cannot be stampeded. And so at the end of the day, you got to be patient for change to occur. And so going through that process, you learn patience. And you know, when patience has its entire work, you're perfect and entire, lacking nothing. When patience has its perfect work, I beg your pardon, you are entire and lacking nothing, wanting nothing. So change helps to strengthen character and some wonderful virtues, like I said, like humility and like patience, you know. And then the ninth reason, remember it's nine, 2009. I hope you were able to take all nine reasons, nine powers of change, as I call them, down, you know. I hope you're really taking notes, because this is really, truly wonderful information. And if you, for any reason, you can't assimilate it all, you can always order a copy of this video or an audio copy and purchase it and just keep learning and keep hearing this over and over again. But the ninth reason is, ninth power of change is that change eliminates distractions, enhancing focus and creative thinking. This is one thing, one power of change that I personally experience. You know, I find that when I in order for me to be able to think clearly and write and prepare my messages and prepare my, to speak, I need to change my environment. I can't stay in my house with my two boys and creative thinking flows. No, I need to change. I need a change of environment. And I find that the moment I change my environment, then clarity comes. You know, I can think very clearly, because all the distractions are eliminated, and then the creative thinking flows and inspiration flows and knowledge flows. And, you know, I tend to be able to hear God clearer and better. So those are the nine wonderful, powerful reasons for change, the nine powers of change. You know, I talk about new opportunities and new platforms to impact and new reach and new blessings flowing into your life, you know, and deepened dependency on God, change of character, improved character, and enhanced creative thinking. So, you know, so now you see that change is a very good thing. Change is good. It is something to be embraced, not to be resisted, you know. And if you're watching this program, this broadcast with a friend, I want you to turn to your friend and tell them, embrace it. Embrace change. Embrace it. Don't resist it, you know. I was actually, as I was preparing for this message, I was actually thinking of, you know, doing a rap song to that. You know, I think it's actually cute. Change, embrace it, don't resist it. Change, embrace it, don't resist it. Sing along with me if you can. I know I'm a lousy singer. That's definitely not one of my talents. But, you know, try, go along with me. I just want to reinforce it and I want to get it down in your spirit. Change, embrace it, don't resist it. 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 But seriously, you know, I want you to really get that, okay? Change, embrace it, don't resist it. Don't find change. You know, like I said earlier, without change, there is no renewal and no growth. And when growth ceases, death begins. That's a quote from me, and you can use it at any time, but please give me credit for it, okay? Without change, there is no renewal and no growth. And when growth ceases, death begins. So change is good. We don't want to die. We don't want to decay. We don't want to deteriorate. Amen. So now I'm coming to this part about embracing change. We're going to talk about embracing change, and then I'm going to talk about the summer challenge that I have for us. Okay, so I'm going to first talk briefly about embracing change. One thing I need you to understand is this, that change doesn't force itself on anybody. Change is a complete gentleman or gentlewoman, as the case may be. It simply makes you an offer. It blows gently in your way and says, here I am, you know, then it's up to you to embrace it or not. You have a choice in the matter, okay? We all free choice, free will, human beings. So that means you can either open up your heart and mind and open your doors to change and say, okay, change, you want to come? Come in. And you can exchange your hand in reciprocity and say, you know, change, take me. I'm coming along with a change. Or you cannot. But again, you know, the choice is yours. But I'm encouraging you to embrace the change, because like you've seen now, regardless of what level find yourself, you know, in society, you know, whether you feel you're up there or not quite up there yet, change is good. And so there's 7 steps I want to talk to about quickly in embracing change. Step 1 is that you need to accept it in your mind as a gift from God. You need to accept it as a blessing. Receive change as a blessing, as an ally, as a friend, not a foe, not an enemy, not a curse. That's the first step. The second step is to take action. You need to take steps towards the change. Like, change offers itself, but then you also need to meet change halfway. And this can mean different things to different people. The action you need to take can mean different things to different people. For some, it's taking that step towards applying that for that new job or moving. For others, it's moving from one geographical area to another. For another person, it might be going to a new church. For another person, it might be restoring a broken relationship. For another, it might be reaching out to a new friend. For another, it might be starting and enrolling in a new network, a professional network, for example, trying on a new doctor, a new hospital. For others, it may be a new hairstyle, a new hairdresser. You know, it's different things for different people. But in order to embrace change, we actually need to take steps towards the change. Step 3 is to celebrate change. You know, when change occurs, celebrate it, like I said, as a gift. Invite friends over, you know, throw a party and, you know, have fun. That's the third step. The fourth step is to announce and declare and testify of the change. And what that does when you testify of the change is that it kind of seals it up and keeps you accountable. Step 5, thank God daily for the change. Write it down in your gratitude journal if you keep one. Step 6, ask for help. Ask for help. That's the 6th step in embracing change. For example, this thing I'm doing on television now is very new to me. It's a very new area. It's a big change. It's a new thing for me. And so what I've done is I've surrounded myself with a team of experts in this field. And so I ask for help when I need help. I need to improve. So the sixth step in embracing change is to ask for help when needed. Don't be too proud to ask for help. Step seven is you need to pray. Pray every day, you know, read your Bible, pray every day. Remember that Sunday school chorus, you know, pray for strength and pray for guidance, pray for wisdom during the transition and the season of change. So you see that there's been a lot of deep information and principles that have been shared in today's broadcast. You know, so far I have talked about the wind of change that is blowing, our resistance to change because of fear, success, and ignorance, the nine powers of change, and I've talked about the seven steps of embracing change. Now we come to the most exciting and perhaps the most difficult part of today's broadcast, and that is the challenge part of it. You know what they say, what the scriptures say in James chapter 2? You know, I like referencing the scriptures a lot. You already know that. But, you know, it says that faith without works is dead, okay? And that not only the hearers are blessed, but the doers. So it's one thing for us to get, you know, listen to a good message and be inspired by it. But it's another thing to actually take action and do something about it. That's when we can maximize the benefit of the message. So, and that's why I'm posing a challenge to us, a summer challenge to us. I call it the Embracing Change Challenge. And this is the challenge. It's very simple. For no less than 21 days, okay, listen carefully now, no less than 21 days in the summer months between July and August, you commit to making significant change in at least one area of life. And I say 21 days because it's been scientifically proven that habits are formed or broken if done consecutively for 21 days. So at least 21 days, it could be more, you know, but no less. And so you make this commitment to, you know, making a significant lifestyle change. It could be about you making a change in your diet, in your residence, in your church, in your hairstyle, in your relationship, whatever it is. And then during those 21 days, you got to journal, okay? So you need a journal. And you journal seven things. One, what new things did I learn? What new things did I learn? Number two, what new things did I discover about myself? Whether they be strengths or maybe they are vices, it doesn't matter. What new things did I discover about myself? Three, how did the experience make me feel? All the negative and emotional, and all the positive emotional feelings about the experience. You journal that. That's the third thing. Four, how was I able to overcome these negative emotions? And five, how long did it take to overcome the emotions? Number six, how difficult, logistically speaking, was it for me to take the challenge and make the change? Okay? And number seven, how did the change impact my life? You then share your story, write it down. Listen to it again. What new things did I learn? What new things did I discover about myself, strength and vices? How did the experience make me feel? Negative and positive emotions. Four, how was I able to overcome the negative emotions? Five, how long did it take to overcome those emotions? Six, how difficult, logistically speaking, was it for me to take the challenge and make the change? And seven, how did the change impact my life? And this is the fun part. In September, I'm giving an offer to three individuals to come on the broadcast to share their story with the viewers, okay? So you take this challenge. And if you want this, a copy of the challenge in print, I have it available. You just email me at totalsuccesscoach@yahoo.com. All the information is going to be available on the screen at the end of the program. So I would need three volunteers who would come on the program and they would come and share their experience. And I would appreciate a diversity in participants, seniors, young adults, you know, diversity in ethnic and professional background. So this is your golden opportunity to meet me, be on television, your claim to fame, okay? So July and August, you take the challenge. We'll be taping the September show, actually, in August. But then you come in on the broadcast in September. In August, it would air in September, and then you share your experiences. I am also going to be taking the challenge. And do you know what my challenge is? Is my hairstyle. Yes, I've worn my hair short like this since my late teens. And my sons and my husband would rather see me with long hair. And each time I go to the hairdresser, my boys will be like, "So what's new? What did you do?" Oh, you know, my husband will be like, "Okay, hi. Honey, did you notice?" I will be like, "No," because it's the same. You know, I just have this thing. I'm resistant to long hair. And anyway, so I'm going to be taking this challenge myself and journaling like you. And in September, I'll be also with these guests, these volunteers, you who are coming to the show to share how it went for us. I'm going to be wearing my hair long with extension or braids during the summer months. So this is going to run for July and August. I trust that you have enjoyed today's broadcast as much as I have, and I've been inspired to success by it. Thank you so much for watching. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep learning. Keep learning. Keep believing. Keep smiling. Keep networking and keep on keeping on. You're on a winning side. Have a great summer. I'll see you in September when together, you and I, you're coming on this show, remember, you're coming on the broadcast. We'll share our experiences about the Change Challenge. Take care. God bless. Bye.